All right, so discovery education, our fifth video here. Quick review, and then our fifth video is going to show us how to actually save and organize my content. What am I going to do with my content? So first of all, we've set up our own account. We have organized so that we know how to do a basic search with keywords. We also have now gone further to where we've not only started searching with keywords, but we've started adding other parameters. And even after that, we've done more advanced searches with those parameters. All that said, what do you do with the video that you find? Now, one, yes, you can just play it, show it to your students, and be done. But for those teachers who are thinking, how do I organize and use this again for next year? There's the My Content button that I'm going to, the My Content section that I'm going to quickly explain and how to sort and organize. So My Content, you can see the end result of what mine looked like. I won't be able to make these go away and disappear for you. But for a teacher like me, to where I've changed grade levels more than once, this allows me to prepare and organize things by grade level or prepare and organize things by subject matter, right? So the gist is, my content is just what it sounds like, your material that you have found and you want to hang on the Discovery Education site. So let's find it. My favorite topic seems to be states of matter. So let's stick with that. I'm going to have that be a third through fifth grade activity because I really like the third through fifth grade level. With that, I'm going to look for more science-oriented videos, and I'm going to actually make it where I'm looking for a video segment. Specifically looking at the idea of trying to find a video that is explaining a vapor. So, I'm in that section here. States of matter, three phases of matter. Really interesting there. Closer look at the states of matter. Solids, liquids, and gases. Solids, liquids, and gases. Looking for something with gases and vapor. Once I find, let's say, defining the three states of matter, not necessarily at the moment, I'm not necessarily trying to organize the most perfect material, but I'm looking for how can I now save and find this material again. So these drop-down menus, those drop-down menus that show up, there's also the add. So the drop-down menu is going to force focus you on where you can put things with. So if I go to the options here, on this video segment of defining the three states of matter that I really want to keep, I add that to my content, it's going to ask where, and it starts to put it into the different videos that I have. So I have several folders. As you can see, I can easily add another folder. I have a science folder here. I'm going to look at, there's plants in motion, nothing really fits. I'm going to add a folder nested in that. Label that folder to be states matter. Yes, the check mark there. And as you can see then, under science, nested within, states of matter. If I highlight that, click, and then add, video is now there. So that means I come back the next day. And instead of repeating that search and repeating trying to find that perfect video, I can go to Discovery Education, my content, and then found within what I've found. States of matter, said video. It plays there. Okay? So, what you've learned today is in Discovery Education, when you have searched for the option of choice and you have found it, you can either go to save in my content, where it'll be save and in your material found on Discovery Education. And once it's there, you can always refer back to my content, go to said material, and be able to use more effectively